This is WDBC News in Seattle. We have just received word that Flight 305 from Portland to Seattle has been hijacked. This is a developing story that we will continue to watch closely.
On a plane bound for Seattle, 1971, a man sipping a cocktail past the young stewardess a note. It sent this briefcase beside me, it's full of dynamite, and I'm prepared to blow up this here flight. Was D.B. Cooper. This was his demand. He would spare Flight 305 and all the folks on board for 10,000 Andy Jacksons and a parachute. He'd even pay for his cocktail to boot. What a lovely day to blow through your head. What a lovely day to blow through the air. Feeling the wind blow through your head. Got off. Cooper got his loot and shoot and seemed quite satisfied. The plane took off a second time, flying real low, and landed for refueling in Reno. The airplane went airborne again, lost in thick dark clouds. Cooper told the stewardess, clear the cabin now. And in a noise the plane filled up with a rush of air. The crew knew Cooper was no longer there. What a lovely day to stumble to earth. Summer songs on the way. What a lovely day to stumble to earth. To the summer songs on the way. Wind through the trees and weeds and swamps of the Northwest. They found some wads of moldy bills. The man remained nowhere. Did he survive or vanish in thin air? 40 years since D.B. Cooper jettisoned the heavens. Disappeared since jumping from that 727. The FBI is mystified and has not closed its file, while somewhere D.B. Cooper cracks a smile.
survive or vanish in thin air?
Thank you.